I love what I love this. Like, you know what I mean?
So what do you think about today's climate in the R&B world? You know, because especially during the 90s, R&B music did such an awesome job in making a standpoint in music, period, right? Then it changed and it went poppy and, you know, it went in different directions and everything like that. So, and then now you have the younger generation actually being disrespectful because I mean, I'm an older chick, but I'm not that old, but I'm not that young either. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I remember a time where, you know, R&B, any people, even hip hop artists would always pay homage to the people before them.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? How do you feel about, like, Jacquees, you know, disrespecting Keith Sweat? Now, side note, you never heard from Jacquees since. Where the fuck are you? Ever since that Keith Sweat situation, what happened to the whole King R&B shit? That nigga went silent. I think his camp stopped fucking with him, if you ask me.
Yeah,
but what do you feel about, you know, the up-and-coming R&B singers not paying homage or actually being blatantly disrespectful to the people who
straight
came before
them? Straight up to the
them?
Face, too. Like,
I honestly, I feel like you just kind of really got to really think about shit before you say it. You just can't be loose-lipping like that. Like, you the king of R&B. Well, what happened to, you know, before you, I would have went straight to Chris Brown. Because
Chris Brown is my man.
Like,
what?
No disrespect to Jacquees.
He had the whole 2000s.
The brother's
and he
talented, but I know me as a singer. I'm not even going to try to compare myself to anybody that came before me because I took inspiration from all of them.
Yes. Because
they did it before me. That's like, you know, that's like your kids trying to raise you. Like, I already lived this life, so you can't teach me nothing.
Yeah, and then the thing about Jacquees that really pissed me off, too, his first major show was in, like, November of 2018. How the fuck are you claiming to be the king of anything when you never even been on a BET award? He been on BET Hip Hop Awards in November. That's the only show you did anything before that. And I had an argument on the Shade Room with some fucking young whippersnapper
about Jacquees.
Because I'm like,
I'm not even engaging
in that.
I
was like,
that's
the thing.
Even...
You know, I talk my shit.
Yeah.
So he was like, oh, you kidding me? Because you know, these young motherfuckers, they start off with the disrespect, like, you dumb as fuck, or you stupid.
Yeah.
And without elaborating on why.
Yeah.
I'm like, okay, so why am I
not
stupid?
Agreeing with the,
yeah.
The norm.
So I'm like, what are you talking about? You know, so they explain, I don't know what you're talking about, because when I would, he performed in my high school. I'm like, see what I'm saying? This is dumb shit. Stay in your fucking place, because the grown folks are talking, first of all. All right?
Wow.
Nobody's talking about high school talk shows and shit.
We talk about
major stage arenas.
Major stage.
You know what I'm saying? He only hit a major stage in November 2018. Then you parading your ass around talking about you the king of R&B?